pretty good. How are we doing, Frankies?
Yeah, all good. So game one went the way of on the spectrum.
On the spectrum, yeah, on the dire side there.
Make sure I got the right name, sorry about that. The Aggron Stonebreaker coming up strong again with the IO ban, and followed on the spectrum, instantly banning out Batrider and Sparta.
And the Clockwork ban.
The respect ban on the Clockwork, very nice there. Very well played by him. He absolutely destroyed it last game. Won his lane convincingly, and then continued to dominate into the mid game, and then having some extremely well placed Lotus Orbs. So, very good there.
Yeah, I was surprised. Did start seeing him fall off at around the 20-25 minute mark. But as soon as he got that Lotus Orb, he was right back in there with his with the initiation plays, and I honestly think just solidified on the spectrum's win chance there.
For sure. Here we are. First pick on the spectrum going into their reserve time as they try to figure out who is the most valuable hero in the pool right now.
They were probably banking on that Clockwork, but cheeky van there from Aggron Stonebreaker, not letting that.
They're on a spatter in the works. But we still have some strong heroes there, like Ricky Mario's on the table. Elder Titan, obviously I don't think they're going to pick him up because he went through the full draft last time.
Yeah, it's definitely a surprise sort of meta hero for me. I wasn't expecting to see Elder Titan anytime soon, but I suppose if you pair him up with the right player and the right team composition, he's so strong, as we saw in the amateur leagues yesterday. Urspirit being picked up first by On the Spectrum.
Yep, he had a great showing last game as well. Like, full aggression all the time. Aggron couldn't deal with it. Mirana was especially fighting from behind, right from the runes, because she was half HP because it's Earth Spirit. Faces Boy getting picked up there by Aggron Stonebreaker. Interestingly enough, because Earth Spirit is actually pretty good against the Faces Boy, with his silence and stun. Just huge amount of damage there over time from the magnetize, so he can't just backtrack the whole lot of it.
10 seconds. I'd say if he is silenced up there and magnetize gets dumped on him, then I mean the void is basically dead, especially in the early game. As soon as Earth Spirit hits six, Faces Void's not going to be tanky enough to be able to survive through the whole thing, especially if there's a backup from the rest of the team. It's going to be interesting to see what they do to try and combat that Earth Spirit. Does magnetize go through BKB?
No, I don't believe it does.
Okay, maybe pick up some heroes. Doesn't. Yeah, maybe pick up some heroes who innately build BKB, thinking maybe Sven could shut down the Spirit quite easily.
Sven's one of my faves at the moment because he comes online so quickly, and with the Eco Saber.
It's disgusting. It's disgusting. Yeah. We saw some, Mads and I saw some disgusting Eco Saber plays with Sven yesterday. Oh.
But Lich getting picked up there on the side of Aggron Stonebreaker, very strong because that sacrifice OTS there responds with the Phoenix pickup. I've seen some disgusting things. Like, the Sun Ray at the moment is just way too strong. Pure damage in the lane.
It's bonkers. We're going to see that scale back a lot when Ice Frog gets his hands on the game after Dying TI6. It's going to be a new game. 6.89.
He's actually banning out the Mirana. So, you know, Mirana did a fairly good showing last game. A good enough showing that they want to ban it off. Radiant
team back. Interesting ban with the Windrunner there. Again, I'm not seeing, unless On the Spectrum have a really, really strong Windrunner hero, a Windrunner player, I'm not seeing why the ban comes out. And sorry, I just talked over the Juggernaut ban there as well. Another very strong meta pick.
Another respect ban there, because they did have a bit of a hard time with the last time. He was certainly like, jockeying for first place on the net worth lead.
Yeah, I mean he unfortunately just didn't get enough of the space that he would have liked, and wasn't really as effective against the Luna as they were probably hoping, as the Luna managed to farm up a Dragon Lance and the rest of her items really, really quickly.
But life stealing picked up by Aggron, that's something you'll deal with the Earth Spirit, alright?
Yep.
Rage being insanely strong, 6 duration, magic immunity. enough to do what he wants to do, and you can pick up Big Abby on top of that if you need to.
Oh, 16 second magic immunity. That sounds broken as all hell.
And yeah, people naturally build like phase boots or power treads, but then they get like a Yasha Sange, and then they can boost around as a lifestealer, doing a lot of damage to a lot of people.
Yeah, and I suppose Abyssal Blade is definitely a really good pickup on lifestealer at the moment, especially for the damage block from Vanguard, which will definitely help shut down that Earth Spirit. He's not going to be able to roll away the passive bash, and even the active one as well. Yeah, it's gonna be interesting to see what On the Spectrum do to pick up something to try and counter him. Timbersaw's still in the pool at the moment. I know you said last game that Timbersaw does manage to deal with Lifestealer deals with Timbersaw alright, but I suppose if you build him correctly, then Lifestealer really doesn't have a chance.
Yeah, well, Timbersaw's very mobile, so if he keeps away from the Lifestealer, that'll be good. But Lifestealer just does chunks of HP, so.
Yeah, that's right. I suppose if Rage is up, then it just negates all the whirling death sort of stuff. Winter Wyvern.
Yeah. Very nice response. They've got a Faceless Void and a Lifestealer, so they pick up the Winter Wyvern. Very good counter to these melee carries, especially if you can get a grouping. So if they're going on the same target, which often they will be, then they can get a nice ulti up for invoking. By Aggron Stonebreaker. So we're still looking for another support here. Something very nice, something with a reliable stun. Maybe a Vengeful Spirit there on the side of Aggron?
Vengeful Spirit, maybe. Lion was picked up by On the Spectrum last time and was utilized so fantastically with the early rotations and stuff. Yeah. So, I mean, Venge is really good this match, especially with the minus armor from Wave of Terror. And again, like you said, the reliable stun with a really, really fast projectile speed is just, it's impossible to try and get away from.
Yeah, at least you see it coming. A lot of heroes are pretty good dodging it.
Mm.
5 seconds. Everyone's out of time. 5 seconds left. OTS under the pump. Who are they going to pick? They get a puck there for their mid lane.
Puck. Interesting. Not what
awesome.
I would have picked.
I love seeing pucks. Ever since watched Miggles from the Teletubbies, as destroying things on his puck, man, I've just been on the puck train.
I remember my first TI was TI4, and newbie in the finals, I think whoever was their mid laner at the time, just being able to get out of every single fight just unscathed with Puck was just so awesome to see. Again, though, not really sure against an invoker, unless you're going to have a lot of rotations from the Earth Spirit, he may struggle a bit.
Yeah, well, I imagine we're going to see Earth Spirit sitting quite heavily in mid lane. We're rotating all the time, like Earth Spirit doesn't need to lane at all.
And
he's going straight for the ganks.
Anti-mage ban, just to keep their invoker safe there.
And Lich as well. Lich often gets quite a big mana pool, just from end game. So, yeah, very safe here. Just looking after their back line.
Yeah, we're still looking for the final support for Aggron Stonebreaker, and the axe get banned out by On the Spectrum there. Oh, this really could be anyone. And a Lunar pick up by On the Spectrum again. Cool. Awesome.
They have to work around the Spaceless Void though, so that's going to be interesting to see how they work that one in.
I'm really liking Aggron's lineup at the moment. It's very strong.
10 seconds remaining.
It's definitely pretty solid, but they need to add something to their support lineup.
They need someone who's going to have a lot of presence in the early game, because really apart from the lifestealer, they really haven't got too much that's going to be able to deal with those early rotations. Especially with Phoenix being around as well.
They're definitely
oriented towards the late game there.
Yeah,
and
well,
again with the Winter Wyvern pick as well, they've definitely got to be careful. On the Spectrum have counterpicked them quite well. I still think Aggron Stonebreaker have got the better picks here, though. And Ricky's picked up. Yes!
They go for the Ricky. So Aggron is definitely has a solid team. It'd be interesting to see if they can turn this into a win, though.
That's awesome. That's awesome. I'm loving the Ricky pick up there.
Yeah, I do love seeing Ricky plays. He's very solid right now, and it's so entertaining to watch.
He's especially with this pseudo support build that's really popular at the moment. There's a lot that he can do because you've got to invest so much in detection, and it's just, you know, sometimes you just forget. You forget that a rookie's there, and they have no heroes on the side of on the spectrum that are gonna be able to spot him out, unlike the Zeus from last game. But
yeah, it's very good, like holding it till last pack there.
Yeah, no counter picks available there. We do have everyone back. We should see pause lift in a sec. Ping's coming out from on the spectrum right down into the bottom lane, and some nice scribbles there.
Yep, Ping getting real excited there on the map, so we'll see what they decide to do here. At the moment, all of OTS is going up into the top lane. Blue's gonna follow suit, head up there too. But yeah, in a mirror image, Aggron is heading all the way down bottom, but we have Pink deviating off to go top, maybe into middle. What's he going to do? He's going to put a ward up somewhere, but yeah, he has correctly called it.
Yeah, I'm probably saying he's probably trying to put up a, most likely going for a defensive ward in their jungle. Actually, no, he's just met up with the rest of the team. They're all playing it safe.
The crew. Ready to roll.
There's some shout outs there. It looks like they're gonna secure this rune. Rookie is gonna place an aggressive ward right in the middle there. It doesn't block any of the camps though. So it's probably just for the vision. Well, not probably just for the vision, it will be just for the vision. And on the spectrum are very, very deep in the jungle there. They're trying to wrap around and maybe catch someone out who's around there. It's not gonna be the case though. They're all playing very safe.
Yeah, they aren't just aren't going to meet anyone. They didn't use the smoke, so there's no big investment there. They secured the rune. There's not going to be no fights here. Aggron has to take their bot rune and let them have top.
Oh, the Winter Wyvern using the skill to give her free pathing to place down a cheeky ward, which has just been pinged out by the invo. Oh no, sorry, it was pinged out by the Winter Wyvern, just making sure that everyone knew that it was there. So that's really, really aggressive ward. They're not going to be solid. expecting too much.
And it's not one of the ones that's going to just be dewarded when you chuck down dewarded in the mid lane.
Exactly.
Really difficult to get. But here we have four people in the middle. Ricky's here, two supports are here. It'll be interesting to see what's going to go down. Here we go, the Rolling Boulder coming in.
The invoker, he's so low, he manages to get a fairy fire. There'll be one last hit from the puck. Oh, the salve's just saving his life. And there's going to be a sunstrike as well. Is it going to do enough? It is. It's going to kill the Earth Spirit. That was really, really well done.
And here's the Ricky.
Ricky's just behind. Is it going to be enough? He's going to be able to jump away and plant a tree and eat it to get that increased regen. That was really unlucky for them over there. Really, really good work on really good work by the Earth Spirit. Really, really early gank, but it was some nice sense from the invoker there to chuck down the
sunstrike. What is
it? The sunstrike, that's the one. Chuck down the sunstrike and get him low enough for the tower to finish him off. So, I mean, I suppose that's pretty even to begin with, although the Earth Spirit got a significant amount more gold than the invoker did there. And he's come back and he's doing the same thing. He's not leaving him alone.
But he's the there as well this time. Just doing a little bit, making sure that they
Is the puck gonna jaunt? No, the puck is going to stay. I think the Ricky is just a little bit too much at the moment. I don't want to risk it too much.
Yeah, well, but currently leading the net worth is actually Spaceless Void, as he sits down bottom here.
He's got 7 assets at the moment. And I think he's making this Luna really work really, really hard to try and stop him from getting any farm. Doing really, really well.
And he's just taking this entire crate for himself, so he's having a baller game here. He's going to be level 4 after this. Quite happy, 2 points in his time walk, so...
mid lane here. Another thing there, and the Sunstrike is gonna take off a lot of health from the Puck. The rotation from the Lich slowing her up a lot. And
that is exactly what we needed. Because Invoke was feeling the pressure there. Like, let's be honest, he had 2 ganks on him already, and he was struggling. When you drop a kill in the middle, it's hard to come back. But he's done it successfully with that nice rotation there and the sticky of Ricky.
He's done it really well. These guys are not giving up on this Invoker. They are punishing him hard just for existing in this lane.
But look at how much damage he's doing to this Puck now. Puck already down to half HP. She's going to be starting to question whether or not it's wise to stay. But here she goes.
Here again coming through. Manages to stun him up. The Puck's there too. Break. And I think just one more last is going to finish him off there. The Ricky is very, very close. I don't think he doesn't have Blink Strike, but the Dust of Appearance coming through, and he's the Earth Spirit. Dust of Appearance still very cool there. Oh, I managed to get him, but the Earth Spirit does fall to the tower as well. The gold being split between the Ricky and the Invoker. God, there is so much happening in this mid lane.
That's insane.
That was so close. That was a really good game sense by the Puck there, just managing to get out of the way of that Sunstrike. That was such a good play, because he definitely would have died. I mean, the Invoker, I'm not sure what level his Exhort is, but that would have killed that Puck. He was far too low. Yeah, level 2 Exhort. That was, no, he wasn't going to survive that.
2 hard gankers just sitting in the middle. This is insane. This is awesome.
God, this is so cool to watch. The Puck is really low, though. He's got to be careful. Managed to bottle up though, he's gonna be alright. The gank again onto the Invoker! He's gonna have to put an ice wall just to try and slow them down a bit, and it is actually gonna work. Although he's very, very low, the Puck's coming through, he's gonna be really aggressive again. Is he gonna get caught by the Sunstrike? He is! Managed to turn this around though. Oh no, actually, they haven't. I thought they killed them. The Ricky is almost got that. He's so close, he's gonna be slowed up by the Dust of Appearance. That was a really good play there by the Earth Spirit, just saving his own bacon there.
Puck just like dodging that Sunstrike was so good, man. It was on point.
Oh, that was amazing. There's so much happening right now. We're even neglecting the rest of the lanes. The Faceless Void is getting ice damaged out by this Winter Wyvern and really, really pushed back. It looks like this Luna has such an early level than Glaives just to try and harass him a bit more.
Fair enough, too. He is quite a hard hero to force out of the lane. He has run out of regen now, so gonna send him some to himself. But up top, we'll just have a quick look, run down. Here we have the Naix, the Lifestealer, sorry, going up against Merchant on the Phoenix. Dire's top tower
is under attack. Merchant using his fire spirits really well, effectively there.
Doing a lot of damage there. Pushing
not,
this,
not letting them overlap.
Lifestealer back, but he does potion up. But yeah, so off lane Phoenix, having an alright time because, like, mid lane is just so intensive.
Mid lane on this Puck, the Lich has rotated, and actually the Ricky's back as well. I'm not sure if they saw that TP or not. There's a sentry ward up anyway. Ricky is going to eat it, and the Ursprit is going to come through, and instantly counter wards. Oh, there's the
and now they've run out of wards.
Four wards just went down in the space of a few seconds. That was ridiculous. Ricky being really, really clever with his wards placements there. Puck being very aggressive on the Evoker again, but he does manage to dodge all the damage coming through there. Faceless Void has been pushed right back to base. He's really, really low on health. But we've got 3 heroes in mid lane. They're all going to wrap around this Puck here. The stun does... the Cold Snap does come through from the Invoker, but it's...
Missing the smoke screen on the Ricky, so unfortunately she's just not able to leave.
Yeah, it was a really unfortunate there. That probably would have paid off quite well. The Lich is invisible. He's still hanging around and they don't know he's there. Smoke screen really fit getting this time. The Puck is very, very low. He does manage to jaunt out of the way though. And the Earth Spirit seems keen to go back in, but he's pretty low. And we can already see that this Invoker is fairly capable of doing a lot of damage to him. And yeah, no, I don't think anything's going to come of that at the moment. This mid lane battle is just absolutely ridiculous.
It's awesome. This is the game 2.
In top lane, the Phoenix is going to Sunray away just out of the range of the Lifestealer, who does manage to jump inside of a range into a creep there, who does open wounds does open wounds the Earth Spirit there and rage just to bring him down.
It's a very nice deer. By the lifestyle. And now he's going in for more. This Phoenix is in
Phoenix
trouble.
Phoenix is really, really low, but he doesn't have the mana to use open wounds again.
Yeah.
He's probably still on cooldown anyway. Again, but this mid lane, Puck has managed to use the Dream Coil. Oh, and the good save there from the Winter Wyvern, just healing his core back up. The Ricky is really low. If he gets an unlucky...
And he might. What is he? He's hanging around. Like, he's tempting fate here. And he's dead. He's off. He's going home.
Very close. He doesn't want to fight there. He knows that Puck can just accidentally kill him, really.
Yeah.
At bottom lane, though... Chronosphere being used up on the Lunar as well, timed in well with the Sunstrike from the Invoker, and they do manage to take down the Lunar. The Lich was there as well, just for a little bit of backup, but turns out he wasn't used. In the mid lane though, coming back, again, the Earth Spirit did roll in, but it wasn't going to connect on anything. The Invoker looking to run away there.
Yeah.
This is an action-filled early game. I mean, I think OT... Sorry, you go
ahead. Have a quick look at the net worth here.
Oh my god.
Very close, yeah. Less than 1,000
And it's all over the place. It's just gone up and down, up and down.
Yeah, but Puck is currently in the net worth of the game. And
bottom lane here, Magnetize being used onto the Faceless Void, who does actually manage to time walk away, negating all the damage. He's going to be fine. Lunar ult was used as well. And yeah, no, time walk again being used just to keep out of the way. God,
yeah,
this is such an even game.
To close
Puck
kill,
again,
but...
just jaunting away. Ricky does manage to blink towards him though, and the extra damage from backstab, cloak and dagger, as it's called now, just finishing him off there. And the Ricky's now level 6. We see he's got tricks of the trade. It'll be really, really cool to see how he's going to utilize this in the team fights here.
Yeah, for sure. And he's doing so well. Like, if we have a look at the net worth, just from sitting middle, he's at 2.5k net worth, same as Spaceless Void. And unfortunately, Invoker's taken a hit though. He's at the same level. But here we go,
there's
down bottom.
So many heroes down this bottom lane. Spaceless Void just bashing away at the laner, but it's not gonna be enough. The Ricky is being a little careful. He's pretty low, and he doesn't know whether there's any wards up. Winter Wyvern healing up his carry there. Again, I think I have definitely underestimated how important this Ricky pick is. We were talking about how the Aggron Soulbreaker lineup is very late game oriented, and OTS has sort of recognized this with the amount of ganks, but the Ricky has just managed to keep them in line and hasn't allowed them to get ridiculously ahead. It was such an amazing pick, and it was really well done to leave it till last.
Yeah. Meanwhile, Nyx up the top, getting some mana for himself, moving towards a arm of Morgana, but down the bottom, Faceless Void.
Just missed that.
Well, this managed to take down the old Lunar. Sunstrike was committed for it.
And Sunstrike were used, yeah. God, there's 8 kills on the side of Aggron, and we're only 10 minutes into the game. The net worth is all over the place. We've got heroes from both teams in the top 5 at the moment. At this stage the game can really go anywhere. I mean, even though Aggron's lineup is late game oriented, they're doing so well at this beginning. Just really going to tell later on.
Yeah. But Aggron, 2k ahead as we go, start to leave the laning phase a little bit. A lot more rotations coming out, and YSY on this Void is certainly pushing this Lunar around. But here we go,
yeah,
he's got some support.
The Wyvern has committed Arctic Burn to try and chase them down a bit, but back in the mid lane though, we see the Ricky and the Earth Spirit, and he's come through. He's going to try and get onto this Invoker again, but the Ricky has managed to soften him up. I'm going to see Tricks of the Trade come out. I don't think it's going to be needed. Magnetize has been used though. I think Tricks of the Trade would probably be a really good option now to try and negate some of the Magnetize damage, because it's really, really low. And the Puck realizes that. Oh, that was perfectly placed. That was so good. The Ricky is really low though, and the Phoenix is going to find him with the Dust of Appearance. Sunray coming
here
out.
Here we go.
Again,
they're
doing
going
so much work. And the Invoker is going to fall down. Lifesteal is here trying to bring down the Sun Egg, and it does just manage with the rotation of the Lich as well. Just that extra last hit. Not letting the Phoenix have his way there. really, really unlucky there for the FedEx, but the puck does manage to get away, and I really think they definitely went the way of on the spectrum there.
Yeah, definitely did. And puck actually managed to pick up a valid discord after that. So, putting off the blank dagger till later. And Nag actually just finishing his armor of Morgaven, so.
Yeah.
We're going to see almost, some big spots coming up.
He's almost level 10. He's very, very close. I think he's just one last hit away. There we are. We see level 10 on him now. He is very strong. It's a very, very quick armlet. And it'll be interesting to see what he goes for next. Bottom lane, though, Chronosphere has been used. Sunstrike has been committed as well. There's so much damage being done to Luna. He's so close to dying, and the ultimate was used as well. Not going to be worth it at all. And that's their ultimate is down for 131 seconds. That's just over 2 minutes. That's really unlucky for the Luna there.
It really is. But yeah, holding steady at about 2k lead in favour of Aggron. But here we have Earth Spirit still sitting in this middle lane. Magnetize is off cooldown, so are they going to go in a game with just the two of them, or are they going to wait for some support? Here we go, Winter Warrior coming in too.
Fail of the squad has been used, didn't manage to connect with the Invoker, just used to clear the wave, but the bait and the Earth Spirit has come in and stunned him up. Magnetize has been committed as well, and Dream Coil as well coming through. Arctic Burn being used. There's so much damage being done to the Invoker here, and he does manage to get off a small combo. Doesn't manage to kill anybody though. The Winter Wyvern is so low. The Rookie coming through, finishing him off as
and
well.
Here
the
comes
Luna's there. The Luna's gonna just die straight away. There wasn't anything he can do. He's just respawned. He TP'd in to try and help out, but there's not much he could do. Venus is going to come in and try and do some sunray damage, but again, it's not going to be able to do too much. He's too low a level. He's just going to get jumped on by the Ricky there. The smoke coming out, slowing him up, but to silence him as well, but Icarus Dive. He doesn't manage to cancel it, though. He almost actually goes all the way back in, but they've already backed off. I think
very
the Lifestealer
fight,
has picked
yeah.
up... Lifestealer has picked up a Blightstone as well, which is going to do so much more damage in these early
yeah.
fights.
Probably going to go straight for the Desolator, or it might stop off for a Yash and Sanj on the way. Very staple there for him.
Mm-hmm. Managed to get hit by the Veil of Discord there, but I don't think that was intentional. I think Puck's just using it as a wave clearing tool at the moment.
Yeah, Puck is under a lot of pressure here to perform, currently leading the net worth on the game, and really trying to just pull this Luna into the carrying position.
Gank. The gank coming through on the Invoker here, but it's really not going to pay off for the Phoenix, who just manages to Icarus Dive away. He's taking some... He took some extra damage there from Cold Snap. He does get smoked up by the Ricky, but he's just managed to get out of the way. And Stretch of the Trade has been used, and he's looking very, very so dodgy at the moment. And the Lich managing to kill the... Wyvern, I'm not sure if Chronosphere was used or not. Yes, Chronosphere was used, just to secure him in place. Actually, no, it wasn't. I tell a lie. According to the fight recap, nothing was used there, but there's been some rotations to the top lane here. Dust of Appearance has been used, and the Phoenix Egg drops! Invoker being taken down by the Earth Spirit, and... the Lifestealer taking down the Earth Spirit as well. Puck did manage to get the Ricky. Dream Coil being used onto the Lifestealer, who's very, very close to taking that Puck down.
Oh, he's
the
so
snap,
low!
The snap
and he's toggling
from,
too!
He's toggling up, trying to keep himself alive. He does use Ray. Oh, wow! That was really, really well timed. The Winter Wyvern ultimate, which would have meant that he would have done a lot of damage to the Lich there, and he may have even killed him. That was a big team fight.
Nax is really like doing work here. And when he shows up to team fight, no one knows about it. He's currently 3-0. Armlet of Morgaven, very strong right now.
Yeah, especially a few patches ago, that the attack speed was just applied even when it wasn't toggled. Doing a lot of work here, and we can definitely see that it is very, very effective on him. And the extra strength as well. Faceless Void looking like he's trying to push down this tower. We actually haven't seen any towers fall in the 16-17 minutes that the game's been going on. It's all been fights, and the Puck does go on the Invoker, but he jaunts out of there, not wanting, not having any follow-up really, although the Earth Spirit is there. He does get pinged out by the Phoenix, who's on his own team.
Yeah. So here we go. Nags is coming in. He's inside something. Here we go. Ricky Murray.
He's inside the Ricky.
Haste rune.
He's put down a sentry wall. They don't know he's there. This could be disastrous, but he does manage to get one. This is done! He's not gonna make it out of there. The Nax just comes through though, and he's doing a lot of damage to the puck. Is Rage gonna last long enough for him to not get in? And the Phoenix does use the egg there, and using cold embracing. They're not gonna be able to get it down. They're gonna do so much damage to him. The Earth Spirit again doing so much work to the thing, doing to the lifestealer there, and the Slitch ult giving the Phoenix a triple kill.
Oh, four kills going the way. Bandit, Ricky Murray, so unlucky getting caught out there at the start. Oh man.
That was not the way he wants that to go. That's definitely a giant turnaround for On the Spectrum though.
And then the egg. The egg was so huge in that fight. Full duration egg in the middle of the giant fight.
I mean, I think Faceless Void only managed to get one or two hits upon him there. That's a giant turnaround. If we just have a quick look at Goldgriff, that is a giant swing. That was almost 4,000. It's only 1,000 ahead. Just under 1,000 ahead for Aggron Stonebreaker now. That was a really big team fight. The big boost that On the Spectrum definitely needed.
So bottom tower is actually gone now as well.
Taken by the creeps though. So, I mean, a handy gold boost for Aggron Stonebreaker. And actually, the net worth has gone in favor of On the Spectrum. That's how it's just pushing them over the edge.
Oh, but yeah, Luna finally getting some gold. Not trailing by 2.5k like she was before.
Managed to pick up the Dragon Lance as well. Obviously, not as early as she would have liked, but got it nonetheless. That was really unlucky for the Ricky. If he had managed to stay alive in that fight, I definitely think that there would have been.
They were going for the initiation, and he got caught out just like pure bad placement. And like, it's insane. And it lost the fight completely.
Yeah, it was really unlucky for him. He did actually. He's got the lifestealer in it, but the Icarus dive just manages to come out before the smoke able to silence him. Lifestealer did commit rage for it as well. So hey, they were really going for this.
It was not to be.
Lifestealer's
actually getting very close to that Desolator too.
Not sure if you saw, but Ricky is using his illusion there to block that camp, which may have been wanted to back for the Luna. They are smoked up here. The Earth Spirit goes straight in, managed to get his sun off, and magnetized as well. He's taking a lot of damage there from the Sunray. Oh, the Corner Spirit and Phoenix are coming through! That's really unfortunate, actually.
Yeah.
That's probably not what they wanted to do at all. The Faceless Boys. The Sunray's gonna take down the Lich. Double kill there, and the Lifestealer manages to jump inside a creep and just save himself there. God, that was not what the Invoker wanted. The Faceless Void getting pinged by the Winter Wyvern.
But yeah,
were any of Aggron Stonebreaker caught in that Chronosphere, or was it just the Phoenix Egg?
It was the Phoenix Egg. It was right on the edge. Like, it was doing damage to the entire fight. So it was like just unfortunate. So unfortunate that they couldn't get in there and take it down.
Really not what Aggron Stonebreaker were looking for there. It obviously was good for OTS. I suppose they could use that to their advantage, but just really, really quick fingers from the Phoenix there. Merchant playing the Phoenix, he's doing a damn fine job at the moment.
He's 6-1-4, he's doing insane work. He was the offlane pick. He's got nearly 3k in the bank, so he's about to drop some big item on us. So that'll be pretty game changing.
Are we looking maybe for a Radiance?
I'd say maybe a Shivers or a Pipe? Honestly couldn't say which way he's going to go here.
Yeah, I mean, a Pipe would definitely be handy against the Lich ult. Because they seem to be getting hit by that quite a bit. No, the Lich is not the level that he would really want to be at the moment.
Lich is doing a lot of work too. Like, the supports have been like performing admirably in this game.
Oh yeah, I think Aggron are doing quite well. OTS are really gonna be looking to try and push and apply as much pressure as they can for the rest of the early game, because Aggron are gonna really start to hit off once Faceless Void and Evoker have got their big items. Lifesteal has jumped aside the brick again, but it is gonna be spotted out by a Sentry Ward. Faceless Void coming through, and he does manage to find the Luna, who does actually get healed up by the Winter Wyvern, negating a lot of the damage there, but the Lich is still bouncing around. The Phoenix Egg has been committed, and he's gonna just get it off beforehand. and he knows that the face of the voice there. He's really, really low. The Earth Spirit comes in and uses Magnetize. He hasn't used it yet. OTS Puck managing to get a double kill there. Earth Spirit did manage to die, but he does manage to get a kill on the Lich with Magnetize. And Lycula again doing so much work there. Oh, and
The Winter Wyvern is still alive,
and he managed to save that puck as well. If that puck had gone any further, he would have been hit by the Sunstrike, and he would have gone down.
Yeah. But meanwhile, Invoker actually pushed their tier 1 middle and did some work on the tier 2. They're ready to get this tower to make it worth it.
They're really looking like they want to see in this tower, and they do manage to get it down, going the way of the Phoenix. That Winter Wyvern was looking pretty low there.
Yeah,
but just managing to miss the Sunstrike from the Invoker, who is doing pretty well. Shiva's Guard coming out on the Phoenix. He has got the recipe, and he is very, very close to having enough for the rest of it.
About 1,000 away, not quite.
Yeah, Ricky doing some dewarding here. Does he have a gem, or nope, he just had his own sentries, and it looks like he's going for a defusal blade as well, which is going to be extremely handy in locking down that Phoenix if they manage to use it before Icarus Dive. Sorry, after Icarus Dive.
Yeah, and, Luna's like starting to get some gold behind her. She's like slowly getting to the position where she can carry the game for them. But Face of Void.
The Faceless Void managing to do a lot of work there. The Puck managing to jaunt out of the way, and the Chronosphere coming through, and Sunray just healing up the Puck there. He manages to heal him before he gets out of the way! I don't think he's going to be able to survive here.
He's going down here. Silence is off.
Puck has silence, and he does have orb as well.
And Faceless for an Earth Spirit. That's not ideal.
That is not ideal at all.
Very well played there. Like, Phoenix and, like, the Firebird and the Icebird are just, like, crushing this game.
It is a game. It is definitely a game of two birds here. There's not a lot of that that Aggron are going to be able to do. I think they can see it slowly slipping away, and we have a look at the net worth. OTS are now just over 5,000 above. Rage being popped by the Lifestealer just to try and get out of the way. The Puck is still keen, though. He's following him around, but
he's so aggressive.
The Lich is coming, and he manages to ethereal jaunt out of the way there.
Luna actually picking up a Hurricane Spike there.
Love this item. I absolutely love this item. It is ridiculously good on Templar Assassin, and it will be equally as good on the Luna as well. Just keep her out of the fight and out of harm's way. Smoke does come out on the Radiant side here. Doesn't manage to catch the Earth Spirit, which I don't think was the intention.
That's gonna pick up some runes, go back to farming. They are winning the exchanges, but honestly, when Faceless Void gets some items behind him, Invoker gets some more items, and like, we've just got the Desolator finished on this Lifestealer, so
he's also recently picked up an Echo Saber as well.
Oh wow. He's gonna like destroy heroes.
Yes. If he gets the space to do so, and really he really hasn't at the moment. Winter Wyvern doing some really, really aggressive wards with Arctic Burn, giving her the free pathing over trees. And Lifestealer jumping inside the
wreck
again.
There we go, they saw it happen.
Yes, so they know he's there, they'll probably get back. Gonna assume that the rest of the team are sitting around, which is the case, Invoker just being behind them with his Forge Spirits. This is
hitting up to push off.
Game. Yeah, he this does have boots of, he does have boots of travel.
There it goes.
Oh, we have managed. Oh dear, I just missed death. That one, unfortunately. Sorry for the folks viewing at home. Chronosphere used to lock down the Phoenix. He's down for 50 seconds. They know the Ricky's there. And the Lifestealer does pop out. Open Wounds managing to come out onto the Winter Wyvern. And the slow from the Faceless Void coming through and slowing him down so much. There was not a lot that he could do there. Right, so they're taking out support. And I'd say the Phoenix is position 3 this game. Would you agree?
Yeah, he was your offlaner, yep. But here we go, Puck is going into their base. Gonna waste some time as he tries to find a nice place he can teleport home.
Yep, the Invoker trying to predict a Sunstrike position there and using a Deafening Blast as well and Tornado. But Puck's no longer there. Puck has long gone and he's gonna pick up an Illusion Rune as well. And this is
action. Here we go, again. The Ricky Maru. Max is infested. Are they gonna be able to get to this Luna?
They're looking like they're gonna find this Luna. Yep, they just managed to spy her out. There are no wards. They don't know that he's there. The smoke's gonna come out. Oh, the Hurricane Pike forced up. He managed to commit the ultimate and the Ricky goes down. He's not able to do anything, but the rage comes through.
Can they save him somehow? One more time. No. Hurricane Pike, too strong. Sorry, Ika save him.
Hurricane Pike saving him from the Ricky there, but it just wasn't going to be enough. Are we going to see? We are going to see a blink and the slow come down from the Illusory Orb and the Dream Core coming through and keeping him in place. The mechanism and Sunray keep the Earth Spirit alive there. They obviously really, really value him. Just waiting for it to run out there, but he's getting really, really close there, but Sunstrike committed by the Invoker there. He's coming through. He's right in the middle of everybody though. I'm not sure he's going to be able to get the full duration off, and he doesn't. And Ice Blast coming through from the Lich and just finishing off that Phoenix there.
This is a disaster. Things are definitely going downhill for OTS.
That's definitely not the way they wanted it to go. Wow.
This is a very sharp swing, man. Luna getting picked off so, like, out of position. Like, no one was around it. She was by herself for miles. But that was really unfortunate, losing her and then going into a team fight like that. Man, they were so close to getting that lifestealer though. I can understand.
They were so very, very close. A really, really good usage of armlet toggling there. Just managing to get him back up to the full 400, 500 health before the damage ticks were coming through. So again, really well played by the lifestealer. I think if we look at the gold graph, we can see another swing right back in the way of Aggron.
Yeah.
Not quite taking it just yet, but they're
we're
really close.
We're down to 1k difference between the teams.
Is a big stacked camp just there. I'm assuming for the Luna when she manages to get around to it.
For sure. Yeah, I think she needs to get in there and take that. She needs to do something about her, like, gold situation. Like, she's just getting crushed by this now. She needs to get something extra to fight.
Yeah, Aggron Stonebreaker's heroes are really, really beginning to show their true colors. They're coming online now. If we have a quick look at the items, I can never remember which button it is.
Yeah, so our Faceless Void here, got a Manta style online, Blink Dagger as well. That was his big purchase, that Manta. Lifestealer, currently taking Roshan, happily. Still,
Ricky.
Same two items.
Ricky there doing a bit of damage as well, and the ice armor from the Lich really slowing up the damage from the Roshan. That Echo Saber is doing a lot of work, especially just on the rest of the team. I don't think Spectrum suspect this at all. There are no wards up in that region. They're not looking for this at all. And I think by the time they do realize it, it's going to be too late. The lifestealer does take it, and he takes the Aegis as well, and that's a very scary looking lifestealer.
Yeah, all of a sudden, the OTS doesn't really want to fight these guys. They can throw down their lifestealer into nothing, and they'll be strong.
The Invoker is looking pretty tanky as well at the moment. I think, yeah, he's looking for his Aghanim Scepter now, but he does manage to get silenced up on the Puck, who's just going to get out of there. Not really worth doing that, especially when he doesn't have any backup at the moment. Some pings coming through on the rest of the team there. I don't think Aggron know that they're here. No, they do actually manage to find the ward that the Ricky put down.
Faceless Void blinking and trying to catch the Winter Warren, but just out of range for that blink.
Yep. Yeah, if I'm going to have another look at the gold graph, it's still in on the Spectrum's favour, but not by much. I think if we see another team fight go their way, they're going to pull ahead.
Luna currently
to be really careful.
Just overtook Lysila for the first time in this game in net worth.
Well, that's interesting. That's really interesting.
But thing is, they have a Faceless Void, and Faceless Void can just instantly, like, you know, not instantly, but can just win a 1v1.
And with the Manta style, it's going to help take down that Phoenix Egg really quickly. Do Illusion Last Hits count on the Egg?
I'm not sure. I think they might count as Creep Hits, but no, not really.
Okay. Well, that's a shame.
Rikimaru, off again. This has been working out for them, and they're just going to keep doing it.
There is a double damage drone. He's just going to leave it alone, because I assume if he's going to pick it up, that it is going to go the way of the Rikki.
There it is.
There's a loader there. They come straight out, but... Oh no, the Ricky's actually doing damage to the lifestealer there, and the Chronos Bear does come out. He's managed to catch two of them in there. The Earth Bear is taking a lot of damage, and Tricks of the Trade coming through. He's still managed to do a lot of damage onto the Winter Wyvern, who tries to heal himself up, but isn't able to stop the magic damage from the Invoker coming through.
So unfortunate there. Man, Stonebreaker's on point. Like, notice there, like, this Rikimaru, this lifestealer, that is going ham.
They're doing so much work. It was lucky for the Luna to get out of there. Obviously, the two supports there weren't their main targets, but still, it's that's a big gold swing. And actually, not as big as I would have thought, to be honest. We're still 1,000 ahead for OTS, who are still leading their work with Puck and Luna, as these guys are pushing the bottom tower, and they do manage to take it down well.
Merchant and with their Shivas online as well, they're moving up here to push this top tower. At the moment, it's only Faceless Void up here, so they're sort of hanging around. But you know, with that teleport, they're going to back off.
Yeah, the Luna is getting pretty strong at the moment. Invoker is 100 gold away from his Aghanim set. Yeah.
Puck just finished the Hex. That's going to be huge. Hopefully, we can see some sick plays coming up with that.
This is going to look good. This is going to look really good, especially if they're able to shut down that lifestealer before he can do any big damage, or maybe even the Invoker, just to keep him in place, and not get off any of those really big teamwork spells that are really, really working well with the lifestealer damage at the moment.
Yeah. Well, I think it's about time the OTS picks up the gem, because there we go. As I say, Kuk buys the gem. It's on the courier.
There's a reason you're the analyst and not me. And they're going to easily take down this tower. They are going to commit the glyph for it, but it's not going to make too much of a difference. The Desolator Echo Saber, not letting them do too much there. Meanwhile, in the middle lane though, Puck and Winter Wyvern and Earth Spirit are just knocking down this tower. The creeps doing a lot of work as well. It looks like
there's five coming in now.
But it looks like these guys are still going for the top tower there. If they're going to take it down as well. There's so much work coming through from the Desolator. They're going to take it down so much quicker than they do. And the Chronosphere has actually been used. The Lich Owl coming through as well. And it manages to get a kill onto the Earth Spirit. Luna does commit her ultimate for the Lich, but it doesn't really do too much. The Phoenix has come through with the Shiva's Guard. And the really big dream call there from the Puck.
And Rikimaru's
to get a full duration off, and Rikimaru does fall down. The lifestealer there, the Faceless Void, dying to Sunray, and the Aegis is popped. Rikki can be seen by everybody. He does manage to use Tricks of the Trade though. He's going to take a lot of damage from Luna's going to take a lot of damage from that. But he does manage
but
to get
Luna's
slowed
in
up.
Where's the Puck? Here he comes. Hex is online.
Puck's coming through. Hex is on cooldown. Oh, the Rikki manages to fall to the Puck. The Puck violence there. Waning Rift is not able to do any work. The Puck
body blocking him with the Puck. This is insane.
Puck was body blocking him, keeping him in place. They're trying to figure out which creep he's in. But they're not able to do anything. The lifestealer hasn't taken control of it yet. And there we go, he does come through.
And then Hex comes out instantly.
Hex comes out
here. Down in time.
I think they're going to be able to. The Sunray doing so much damage there. The Luna.
67 gold. And it looks like they're taking the tier 3 is down. They're going to take this Rex.
That's a full team wipe. The lifestealer is down for 67 seconds. I'm going to assume he's got buyback, which he doesn't. Have any buybacks?
There's no buybacks.
There's no buyback. Oh no!
Out of your mind. Those blocks were insane. Like, out in front. Fearless.
That was incredible. That was so well done from the Puck there. And the Phoenix using the Sunray, not only to heal the Puck and to deal damage to the Lifestealer, but it's multi usage there. The Puck is now full health. And
yeah.
Everything's back off cooldown.
Lifestealer's down for 30 seconds. They're going to use this window.
Luna will be up again in 29
seconds.
Look at
this Puck in the trees.
He is very, very close to the Luna though. He does get slowed up. About to force the Hurricane Pike. Oh my god, they managed to get the Dream Call. There's no way he's going to get out of there. The Sunray is doing so much damage to the Rikki. He's going to fall to the burn damage as well. The Invoker manages to heal himself up, but he's not going to be able to get out of there as well.
And another is going to drop.
That's another team wipe. The last deal is still not back up. I don't think they're going to get out of this. The Luna is pushing every single building in the base at once. I really don't think they're going to be able to come back from this.
Lysander is alive, but I don't know if he can do it by himself. Puck is just too aggressive.
He's definitely not going to be able to do it by himself. The plays from the puck, the absolute plays. Sorry, I made a small mistake there. The Invoker was yield scepted by the puck. Didn't yield scepter himself. He definitely wasn't able to get out of there. I think Aggron are just letting this go through, and GG is called by their captain.
Man,
that was puck so well played from on the spectrum. It was ridiculous, and everything does manage to fall down. Well played from on the spectrum. Their early game aggression just keeping Aggron Stonebreaker out of the way, and they just weren't able to do anything. They weren't able to take advantage of their late game build. They showed promise, but it just wasn't to be today.
Man, what a game.
Best what a game.
OTS. So I will catch you guys on the stream for the analyst desk.